needed. We'll begin with Ms. Harrison with her two-minute intro.
Good evening. My name is Rose Meza Harrison, and I'm running for judge of the 105th District Court. Born and raised in Benavides, my parents instilled in us the importance of God, family, and a good education. They taught us good values like hard work, honesty, and integrity. These lessons my parents taught us made me who I am today. I'm a mother, a grandmother, a sister, an aunt, and a friend. And I run my own family and criminal law practice here in Corpus Christi. In the legal field for over 20 years, I worked my way up from a legal secretary to an attorney while a single mom. One of the reasons I decided to run for this position is because I've seen too many incidents of family violence in our community. As a mother and a grandmother, I want my family to be safe. And so what I'm going to do is put my 20 years of experience to work to keep your family safe too. I will also work to ensure that our jails are not overcrowded and that our cases are moved in a timely manner. I will be fiscally responsible for the monies used to run the court, and I will be respectful to everyone that enters my courtroom. I believe my legal experience gives me a unique perspective that will best serve the people as a fair, just, and impartial judge. I've always worked hard, and I promise you that I will work hard to be the best judge of the 105th District Court. I will administer justice equally, and I will be fair and impartial under the Constitution and the laws of the United States. I humbly ask for your vote and support. It would be an honor and a privilege for me to be your next judge of the 105th District Court. Thank you.
Thank you. Now for Mr. Pulcher's opening statement.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. My name is Jack Pulcher. I'm running for the 105th District Court on the Republican ticket. When I grew up, my parents were both teachers, and back then, teachers really didn't make big salaries. They were able to raise five kids, put them all through college. Three of them are prosecutors, including me. I've been married to my wife, Selena E. Barbo, for 13 years. I graduated from Texas A&M in 1994. Went to law school, South Texas College of Law. When I got out of law school, I came back to Corpus Christi. I started working with my mom, she was an attorney, and we were doing employment law and family law. And then in 1999, I was hired by Laura Jimenez at the DA's office. I've been working at the DA's office as an attorney for 15 years, around the courthouse, in the courtroom. I have over 50 jury trials, 60 bench trials, numerous motions to suppress hearings. I actually been working as an attorney in the courtroom for my entire legal career. I just got through picking a jury 2 hours ago. We will start testimony in the morning. The 105th District Court, this is a serious thing. It involves people's lives. It involves the death penalty. It involves people's freedoms. And more importantly, it involves relationships between families and their children during divorces. This is a serious position. I ask that when you go to vote, when you go to the 105th race, I'm the first on the ballot, and you pick me. I'm the only Jack in the entire election. I ask for your vote, and I'm the only qualified candidate in this race. Thank you.
Thank you. Our first question, we will be directed at both candidates. We'll start with Ms. Harrison first. What makes you think you have the right temperament to be a judge?
Well, I've always considered myself to be a people person. I've always been able to get along with people. I've been involved in my community as a leader in many organizations, and I've been able to get along with the folks on the board that I represented. I raised three children, and I have two grandchildren, and you have to have some amount of of, you know, good temper, let's just put it that way, and patience. So I believe that I have the qualities needed to be a good judge, and I believe I can have the best demeanor, I believe, in the courtroom that's needed for the 105th. Thank you.
And now, Mr. Pulcher.
Does being married for 13 years count? I've been a prosecutor most of my legal career. I've had to deal with mean, aggressive, harsh defense attorneys, Rudy Garza for one. I treat everybody, even though they may not like me, I might not like them, I treat them with respect. I treat them like a friend. And everybody gets a fair shake whenever I do deal with them. So I think I do have the demeanor to be able to do this position correctly.
Thank you. Our next question is for Ms. Harrison. Where have you worked, and why do you think you can move forward quickly concerning citizens' needs?
Okay, I guess you have to know my story, and basically I've worked, the first work ethic that I learned was from my grandfather. He owned a little grocery store in Benavia, that's right across the street from the Catholic Church, and he taught us, you know, how to treat customers. So I learned how to work hard, and I dusted the shelves and the cabinets and everything. And I've worked anywhere from a jean factory. I used to work in a blue jean factory. And I used to be a realtor, you know, and I was a paralegal for over 15 years, put myself through college and law school. And so I believe that I have what it takes to be the best judge on the 105th District Court. Thank you.
Thank you. This next question is for both candidates. We'll start with Mr. Pulcher. Do you support giving drug offenders the harshest possible sentences or ending the war on drugs?
I don't think giving harsh punishments to people who are caught with drugs is the answer, because when they get out of prison, I guess you're saying incarceration, they're still going to have the drug problem. They're still going to go back to their friends where they did drugs before. We do have some programs here in Nueces County. We have the divert court, which first time offenders, if they qualify, they go through this program. It's about a year, it costs about $1,000. They put them through programs to try to get them off the drug so that we don't have this vicious cycle of seeing them every 2 or 3 years. Now, once somebody does become a lifetime criminal, I believe that they need to be punished appropriately. Thank you.
Ms. Harrison.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Same question.
Okay, I believe that drugs can take a toll on our children here in our community, and I'm very concerned about the drug issue. And there is a program that we have now that the district attorney has that goes from basically someone who uses drugs not in a very harsh way to those that are hard users. So I believe my punishment is going to be depending on what type of user they are and how hard a user they are. And if they are people who are like what we call pushers in our community, those are the ones that I'm really going to be making sure that go to jail and get the highest sentences possible. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is for both candidates. What is your opinion on family law cases that the current judge has let drag on for years in that court? Would you render an opinion on the open cases as is or rehear the case? We'll start with Ms. Harrison.
God, that's kind of a tough question. To rehear a case and start all over again, I think would be very difficult. But if I am on the bench and those cases are still up, when I start my term, I guess I'm going to have to hear them for sure. So I guess the best answer to that would be I'll just wait and see where that is. And if I can run them as quickly as possible, I'll do just that. I'll make sure that they get priority. Thank you.
And Mr. Pulcher.
Could you repeat the question, please?
What is your opinion on family law cases that the current judge has let drag on for years in that court? Would you render an opinion on the open cases as is or rehear the case?
It sounds like the cases haven't been heard yet, so my approach would be to set aside a certain amount of time every month just to address the family violence cases, since A lot of these crimes have become third-degree felonies over the last few years. The court system has got bogged down a little bit with them. We have victims who it's hard to get to prosecute the person they love, but they still need to be addressed. And I think if we set a week every month or 6 weeks of just having family law cases, trials, set for trial, that it will clear up that backlog. Thank you.
Thank you. And here's our last question for both candidates. We'll start with Mr. Pulcher. How will you handle the transition period from the incumbent judge's staff to yours?
I don't believe in firing people, especially around Christmas time. These people are not just working there for 4 years and then losing their jobs. I think if I can get along with the staff, we get a probationary period. I think that if we work and our personalities match up, which if the Judge Angelica can work with these people, I'm sure I can. So I don't see replacing the staff until we have a conflict in personalities.
Thank you, Ms. Harrison.
Well, that's a tough question, but I've not even considered yet my staff, and I will take into consideration the current staff that's working and probably meet with them and ask them if I win, do you want to stay, first of all? Some of them may have other plans, but yes, definitely, they would probably have the most experience and know the court, know what's going on. So that's the first thing I would do is ask them, do you want to stay? And then I'll interview them and see what their qualifications are and then see if anybody else is interested, and then we'll just go from there.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Return to your seat.
Thank you for your questions. Thank you for being here.
Oh, I'm sorry. You get a closing statement. So sorry. Ms. Harrison.
Okay. Yes. Again, my name is Rose Meza Harrison, and I would love to be your judge. I've been living in this community for many years, and my children are all grown and gone now. My baby is 30 years old, and this is my heart. This community is my heart, and I want to make sure that I'm here to be your judge. I believe I can be a good judge. I can make sure that your families are kept safe. This is something I'd love to do. I'm a very hard worker, and I can assure you that I will work hard to be your best judge of the 105th District Judge of Court. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Pulcher.
Thank you. Whenever y'all participate in sports, or you take your kids out to the soccer field, or you watch the Cowboys versus Texans, you expect that referee of that game to know the rules, know the regulation, know the fundamentals of the game. It should be the same thing with a district judge. You should be looking for someone who knows the law, knows rules of evidence, has been in jury trials, has been through voir dire, knows the code of procedure, knows how the court works. So because one day somebody, you might end up in that courtroom or someone you may know, and you would want to know that the judge sitting on the bench is going to make the right appropriate decision and apply the law correctly. I ask for your vote. Thank you.
Thank you. May you return to your seat in the audience.